Hey guys, it's me DoniBobes here and welcome to another Minecraft Let's Play video. And in this video, I will be telling you how to become a Minecraft YouTuber. 10 basic steps you need to become a Minecraft YouTuber. And the video you're seeing on the screen right now is a video that I recorded in the past. So, so I'm from the future, right? Right? Am I right? What am I talking about? Let's get straight into it. Step one, I've written these steps down so I know a little bit of the gist of where I'm coming from. I don't want to do too much off the top of my head or I'll just start rambling on like I'm doing now for hours on hours on hours. But yes, step one is a very basic step. You're going to need the actual game. I know you're like, oh, of course, that's a given. But no. Many people decide to download Minecraft illegally, not naming any names, but a lot of people like to download Minecraft illegally. And when you're looking into mods and trying to join different servers, you always find a lot of problems with your Minecraft copy. So I highly suggest that you get the actual game off the actual Mojang website, because trust me, you do not want the problems later. Step two, equipment. This is probably one of the most important steps. You're going to need decent equipment. For microphone, I used a Snowball Ice blue microphone. It's alright. It's not bad, but it's definitely one to start off with. You should probably look into getting more advanced ones. But this is very decent. This is it's very good quality mic, especially for the money. It cost me about £50 or about $100. A decent pair of headphones. Nothing too expensive. Headphones come and go. If you want a headphone that lasts, you should definitely look into a nice pair of Logitech headphones. And a computer. This is definitely the biggest one. You need a computer that's able to like run Minecraft, run your recording software. Oh yeah, and recording software I need to talk about. My recording software, I use OBS, but I'm recording on a Mac. So if you're recording on Windows, you're going to need a different recording setup. I would suggest Fraps. But Fraps is, you're going to have to pay for Fraps. It's not free. You can use like a trial version of Fraps, where it lets you record up to 2 or 3 minutes, but you don't really want to faff about with that. But yeah, your computer, it has to be able to run your recording software, your microphone recording software, and I use Audacity, by the way, and Minecraft, your web browsers, your Twitch, everything you need. And trust me, you should just go through with it now and make sure, I hit my mic there, just make sure you hit your, not hit your, see, this is what happens when I try and talk on the top of my head. Just make sure you have a computer that's able to run all your softwares at the same time. And later down the line, you don't have to keep spending money on more computers or whatever, unless you're a baller. But number three, this is a huge one. All right, you have to be either entertaining or informative. You can be both. You can be entertaining and informative. A lot of Minecraft YouTubers are, but you're gonna have to, like, you can't just be dull and sit there and talk, "Hi, my name is DoniBobes and I'm recording a Minecraft Let's Play video. Can I have 1,000 views, please?" It doesn't work like that. You have to actually, try and talk, try and act happy, even if you're not really happy. I hope you are happy, but even if you're not happy, you got to act as if you can, as if you're happy to talk about Minecraft, which you should be. Minecraft's the best game in the world. Come on, I was introduced to it like last year, and oh my god, the best experience of my life. Oh, my life is quite sad then, isn't it? But you have to be, otherwise you can be informative. A lot of people search up Minecraft videos when they're unsure on something, usually redstone, what else is there? Commands, there's loads of different stuff, world seeds. A lot of those get quite a lot of views. But that could definitely attract some revenue and attract some viewers to come watch your videos. Step four, I believe, are on. and that is, you gotta love making your videos. You can't just sit, I touched on this a bit before, but you can't just really, like, you can't hate what you're doing. You, obviously, making videos is the funnest thing, and also, step five, you've gotta have basic knowledge of editing, alright, because this is a huge one. You know, as long as you can just sort stuff out on a timeline, you can put the videos, sync it up with the music, with the voice, unless you've got a recorder that records both of you at the same time. Your Minecraft has got to be able to run. I use my Windows laptop to edit whenever I'm, and I just use my computer to record. But I use Premiere Pro, Adobe, and or you can use Final Cut, which is the same version but for Mac. And yeah, it's just, you just gotta love making videos. It's the funnest thing. I don't know how you cannot love it, but yeah, that's definitely a big step. Step six, however, you've got to find your target audience. You don't want to just go out there and start screaming at a microphone while not knowing who you're directing to. Your audience are your, like, are the main reason for your success. You've got to, how do I put this? You've got to connect with them. You got to connect with your audience. I think that's another step. But yeah, you have to make sure, like, you reply to comments, you reply to tweets as much as you can. Unless you're on 7 million subscribers and you got to reply to a lot, but even then, try and make an effort. Try and make every fan feel special. They should be. Step seven, you've got to try and make friends with different Minecraft YouTubers. Like, try and take some tips of them, and they should definitely direct you in the right way. There's a lot of people that you find that are on the same level as you, some even higher. And you can get to know each other, try and fit a group together, if you know what I mean. Just make friends and try and have fun with what you're doing. And if you're commentating, it's a lot easier when there's someone else in the thing. It's because you can talk to your audience and you can talk to your friend at the same time. Step eight, we've already touched on this a little bit, but yeah, connecting with the audience. Make sure you do, because your audience, I swear, they're the biggest part of your success. You got to just make sure you reply to as comments as much as you can, especially in the early stages when you only got to reply to a few comments. Just make, try and include your viewers in videos and etc. Step nine, have a variety of videos. You can't just keep spitting out survival modes. This is my SMP server. This is video one, video two, video three. You've got to distribute your videos wildly. You got to use, play mini games. You can do parkour challenges. You can even do challenges set by your subscribers. That's a big one. You can ask your subscribers. That's a great way to get your subscribers involved. You do not understand how talented some of your subscribers are. The fan art you receive, everything, you're just going to be blown away by their actual skill. Step number 10, the final step, you've got to watch others for inspiration. You've got to look at these big YouTubers. You've got to know how they got there. They never got there just sitting on their bums all day. Oh, and at a computer screen, sending messages to every single one on YouTube saying, subscribe to my channel now. They had fun with what they were doing. They followed the other 9 steps. And yeah, they're huge successes as they are now today. If you did like this video, make sure to like it. Share it with friends, of course. Share it with other people that you think need help starting up a YouTube channel. And just make sure you enjoy what you do, guys. This is DoniBobes. Signing out. I'll see you a lot later. Peace.